Open your Bible. Let's stand up and open our Bible to the book of the beginnings. Let's go back to the beginnings. The book of beginning, chapter 6. You know the book of beginnings? Let's go to the book of beginning, chapter 6. And can we, our beloved sisters, stand up for a while? Let us open the word. Already from verse 11 to 14. Amen. Are we there? Can I go now? The earth also was corrupt before God, and the earth was filled with, and God looked upon the earth, and behold, it was corrupt, for all flesh had corrupted his way upon the earth. And God said unto Noah, the end of all flesh have come before me, for the earth is filled with violence to them, and behold, I will destroy them with the earth. Make thee an ark of buffer wood. Worms shall thou make in the earth, and shall pitch it within and without with pitch. Luke 17. Luke 17, I will read verse 25 to 27. But first must he suffer many things and be rejected of this generation. And as it was in the days of Noah, so shall it be also in the days of the Son of Man. They did eat, they drank, they married wife, they were given in marriage until the day that Noah entered into the ark and the flood came and destroyed them all. Father, bless your word to our heart in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Papa, quicken something to us individually here this afternoon in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Papa, your word is two-edged sword. Let it cut me also in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Dependable God, word you could give for all this time, oh God, bring in conviction into genuine repentance in the name of Jesus Christ. Bring us, oh God, to challenge of the hour we are living in now, oh our Father. That as your word has said, we shall not be condemned along with the world in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, blessed Father. In Jesus Christ's name we pray. Give me a say, Papa. For I have always speaking with two mortal lips. Let me disappoint me and the way may appear. For what is the whole point of today's service? Let me decrease, oh God, I am increased. For our children want to have you speak to them. Speak to them, Papa. Speak to our soul. Speak to our heart. In the name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus Christ's name we pray. You may sit down. God bless you. Praise the Lord. Brethren, want to look into this thought that God had quicken to me. The title, what I title, the Ark of Noah, a sign of imminent judgment. the ark of Noah, the sign of imminent judgment. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Amen. As we read in the Bible, the Lord begins to commune with a man. He is always one man. He will pick to that what he wants to do. Whenever God wants to make a move, he picks a man. That is why it is dangerous if you ignore that man at that hour of time. You will find yourself outside the will of God, yet serving God. Amen? When God wants to make a move, he's always picking a man. And that is why it is dangerous. If he ignore that man, he will be outside the will of God, yet serving God. Praise the Lord. So, in that generation, in the course of my study, I want to pay great attention, because what I want to say, God quickened to me. And when I receive such messages, faith or fear will catch me. Because when I was debating with another message I have in mind to preach, I had it clear. He said, which message could be stronger than the sign of imminent judgment? Amen. He told me, say, which method could be stronger than a sign of imminent judgment? So, are the people of that generation? Remember, you may not understand, it was at the seventh generation that Enoch were taken in the rapture. It was at that seventh generation that this judgment struck the earth. It was also at that seventh generation that this judgment struck the earth in that hour of time. For in the book of Genesis, if you look at the story of Lamech, before that is the father of Noah. Lamech, the father of Noah, in the book of Genesis chapter 5, verse 21 to 31, if you can read that story. They say Lamech was 777 years. So when that judgment struck, it was 777. Then it was over. Praise the Lord. And remember, one of the interesting things in that hour of time, they have been worshiping God. They were serving God. That is, they were not serving God, because God had already under Seth restored worship after Abel. God had restored back worship at the altar of stone. At the altar of stone where they offer blood sacrifice. Amen? At the altar of stone, because that was the altar that Noah also erected. When he came down from the ark, he erected the altar of stone and poured blood there to worship God for saving him from the flood. So, those people of that generation, they were actually serving God in the pattern that God initiated in Eden. Amen. They were busy serving God very well, according to their own revelation that God gave to them. But it was among those worshippers that God called one of them, gave him a message to go back to them and tell them what to do to escape judgment. You see? It was among those church people at that time that God raised up a man in the person of Noah and gave him a message to go back and tell his children, this is the way of escape. And what is the way of escape? The ark. Amen. Hallelujah. And the Bible said that great evangelist, in obedience to the word of God, the fear of judgment, and he began to build the ark. Tradition have it that ark took Noah 120 years to be completed. Amen. He took Noah 120 years to complete the building of the ark. So, for 120 years, the message of escape route, being the ark, will be preached to the people by the construction of the ark. Amen. Praise the Lord. So, now it had expected that the children of God, people of the earth, at that time would have visited to Noah and joined Noah in the construction of the ark being escape route. Amen. Because that is why William Branham said, when you believe, you become consigned. Amen. When you believe, you become consigned. You can't busy yourself for the, consign yourself for the thing you don't believe, you don't have interest in. Is that true? So, because they have no interest, and because the message that Noah came with was a strange message, to them, that message was strange. Because he had told them that the Elohim, the eternal God that changes not, has spoken to me. He said, he's coming to destroy this world. He said, he is coming to destroy this world and destroy it with water. He told me he will cause rain to fall for 40 days and 40 nights non-stop. By it, he will sweep away the whole world. Ignore him and treated him as a tattler. You know why? Because in their days there was nothing like rain falling. Amen. In their days on this earth, there was nothing like rain falling. You can see clouds gather and then they come down. There was nothing like that. But he that spoke to him specializes in the impossibility. That is why the things of faith, always look very impossible. So, Noah, they ignore him and continue their church. Continue baptizing in the title of Father, Son, and Holy Ghost, ordaining women preachers. And consider Noah's message as a strange message. Don't listen to him. Since we were born, right from the death of our forefathers, even Seth, even Methuselah, have you ever had a rain fall? They said, don't mind him. They said, don't mind him. So, they left the building of the ark to Noah and his only family. And yet, they continue to offer sacrifice on the altar of stone. I want to pay attention. They continue to offer sacrifice at the altar of wood and stone while the ark was being prepared. Hallelujah! 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 They are busy offering sacrifice at the altar of wood and stone that their forefather has given to them. Never know that God has taken a bend and the message has changed. Amen. God has took a bend in his journey and he's dealing with them. And when he took a bend, the message changed. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So, while they were busy worshiping God, never know that God has left the altar of wood and stone. He's not in the ark. God's attention is in the ark because what he asked me to do. Every other person that be worshiping God here, you are worshiping in disobedience. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. When we talk, you say we are criticizing. We are not criticizing. We are talking of Bible. We are not talking of theology. Praise the Lord. So listen. When that ark was there looking at them, it was a sign of imminent judgment. Amen. Anybody that passed that ark and going his business to his church, he didn't know he was looking at as an instrument of final judgment. Anybody that carry a Bible that time and go to that denomination and passing that ark and look at Noah and see this old man. This old man. You never know that was a sign of an imminent judgment. Praise the Lord. Until the ark was completed, they were watching the ark. The work continued. It's a gigantic thing, three-story building. A gigantic edifice, three-story building. And they were watching the thing, watching the thing, watching the thing, until the ark got completed. And they were carrying on. Social life continued. Religious life continued. Brethren, the day of rapture, they are not, as it is now, it will be the same way. Motor will be flying in this express. Container will be going on this express. A airplane will be taken up at the Kenya airport. Hallelujah. Amen. So, when the hour completed, to their amazement, after they have ignored Noah, the animal listening to Noah. Animals heard his message and believed it. Human beings rejected the message, turned it down, but animals believe. And William Brown was telling us, giving us an analysis. He said, find out every places where earthquake occur. He said, you can never see animal caught there in that earthquake. He said, because there's something God built, a different God built inside them. When danger want to come, there's a natural instinct, they will move away from that side. Amen? So, they just imagine that after Noah had completed the ark, imagine church leaders, church doers, they were watching animals flooding into the ark every day, one by one. Which type of church is this? Now, wow, see this is my church. You don't feel that in beauty. No only animal they enter the church. Yesterday, I see pussycats. Today, I see dog. They are going to their church. Hey, now, wow, for the church, animal church. They will make jest. They will say, I'm nothing. Look at their church building. They said they are bright. Now share the day side of inside one bush. Now they're near canal. It is a God there. God no there. I bet come and go to the church. Amen. But God hide himself in simplicity. God is not a gigantic edifice, even though we want one. Amen. Hallelujah. So, animal eventually become member of that congregation. And Noah was their pastor. Amen? And the Bible said, God gave them grace period of 7 years. And see whether there could be a change of heart. May we not be caught red-handed in the name of Jesus Christ. Whether there could be a change of heart. He gave them answer 7 days. And on the 7th day, when they refused, Bible said God came down by himself and locked the door of the ark and took the key away. Why? Noah being a godly man, when that flood began to come down, I can see many of the hypocrites. I can see those hypocrites believing that Noah is their uncle, Noah is their cousin, Noah is their friend, Noah is their business partner. They will come knocking. Please open this way, talk not through. Open this way, talk not through. No, it is too late. No, it is too late. And Noah being a man, a godly man, the tendency will be, oh, my brethren will not perish. He will throw the door open at the dying minute. And they will enter that ark, not because they have repented, but because they have seen danger. They will enter that ark, not because they have repented, but because they have seen danger. So many are in the church because they saw danger, not because they have repented. So many are here, not because they have repented genuinely to accept Christ, having been convicted of their sin. They repented of their sin and then look for Christ for salvation, but because of danger. Amen. But because of danger, they are seen outside, so they decide, since I cannot go to native doctor, let me go to church. So God is said, open it, locked the ark and took off. Amen. 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 The Bible said the only window in that door was on the roof of the ark. It was on the roof that God asked Noah to put the window. So Noah yourself inside the ark, look up, for only from up you can get your salvation. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. So the people gamble with their life, gamble with their life, gamble with their life. Hallelujah. Until all of them end up. This great religious empire that you see in the book of Revelation chapter 7, that wonderful woman, that wonderful royal woman with purple, the Bible says she's sitting upon many waters, and the water are nations of people. Now she has dominated. They are believing that they are worshiping God. Amen. What a high point of deception. They believe that they are worshiping God, and they are sincere. They are sincere, and yet they are sincerely wrong. But would they believe? Would they believe? Would they believe? Would they believe? How can they believe when they pray their head that go? Deliverance take place there. Healing take place there. Amen. Healing take place there. Deliverance take place there. So how can they believe? So how can you say that God is not here? Go and convince him now. Was Noah able to convince those of his days? He couldn't convince them. Amen. I want to show you something. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now, all the people of that day, all of them perished in that flood. A type of all the religious organization today that have rejected the message of the hour. All of them make up together. Equal. Call them evangelical. Call them Pentecostal. Call them Orthodox. Call them charismatic. They make up the great religious empire. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The type of the Noah Ark is on today. Praise the Lord. In 2000. 2007, there was history on the news in the net that the Noah's Ark had been discovered on Mount Ararat in southern Turkey. Who have heard about it? Who have heard about it? Watch. Watch. Watch the ark. Watch the ark of Noah in southern Turkey, buried inside a rock. And God preserve it. Now, my question is, why is it that at this seventh church age, it God allowed mankind to see this ark? Why is it that it is at this seventh church age? It was on the seventh generation that that event, that this ark was constructed to save life. And again, God allowed this ark to be buried there inside the stone all the hundreds of years. When we enter again the seventh church age, being the seventh final church age of the Gentile, God dealing with the Gentile, God allowed this ark to be discovered. And as I'm talking to you now, the Turkish government has built the heart a tourist center for those who want to go and see this ark. He has built the heart for them there in southern Turkey. So when I can come there, all the tourists that went to travel to Turkey in order to see this ark, there's a heart that they built on the mountain there for tourism who want to go and see it. Why is it that God allowed the ark to be discovered in this age? It is because what happened in that generation is about to happen again. It is because what happened in that day is about to happen again. Brethren, what we read in the Bible say the earth was filled with violence. Was that the proportion of the violence that is on the earth now that can be compared to that day? The type of violence. Oh, you never see anything. Go into the net. Go into the internet. Come and see this Islamic State organization, what they are doing with human beings. Human beings are being butcher like dog until they had trained up young children of 8 years to slaughter a man and chop up his nose, his head. Children of 8 years. But a beast peel. There's a video with Chile. He will not show it. Because if he show it here, some people here will not be able to eat for the next 7 days. How many people are killing human beings like dog? Human life had no value. Talk of violence. There is no part of the globe now. You don't hear one violent or the other, one terrorist organization or the other place or the other, and their job is to waste human life. Amen. Talk of violence. The Bible said they were given in marriage and they are being married. What was wrong with marriage? God himself instituted marriage. Amen. God himself is the one that instituted marriage. Therefore, what is wrong with marriage? It was because the marriage they were contracting was contrary to the marriage that God instituted. Did you hear me? Amen. It was the marriage they were going on in that day, it was contrary to the marriage that God instituted. Amen. I have in my phone an old man of almost 70 years. They were kissing another old man in marriage wedlock in America. Amen. One old man will kiss another old man, so they were married. Had another video of another man married another man. This one will give this one ring as a husband. The other man will give the other man ring as a husband. So they are husband. Then another woman will give another woman ring as wife. and the other woman again will give this one another this woman ring as wife. So they are wife. Hallelujah. Amen. Brethren, God is alerting us that the danger button is on. The danger button is on. Praise the Lord. Amen. John chapter 6. May the Lord help us in Jesus' name. May we not run this race in vain in Jesus' name. John chapter 6. I want to read from verse 25. Hallelujah. I quoted the scripture last time. I need to quote it again. When the people therefore saw that Jesus was not there, neither his disciples, they also took shipping and came to Capernaum seeking for Jesus. To do what? You are looking for Jesus. Why are you looking for him? You see? People like this, because it is a spirit. The spirit that entered the people that day, those spirits are still alive. And they are still entering human beings today to look for Jesus, for what they will eat. They are not looking for Jesus because they are looking for eternal life. They are not looking for Jesus because they have heard his word. They are not looking for Jesus because they are convinced that this is the gift of the Son of God that takes away the sin of the world. They are not looking for Jesus because they want to go into a relationship with him. They are not looking for him in that way. Praise the Lord. I say, it is a relationship that produces commitment. It is a relationship that produces commitment. If there is no relationship, there is no commitment. Praise the Lord. Jesus, now verse 25. And when they have found him on the other side of the sea, they said unto him, Rabbi, teacher, why comest thou hither? And Jesus answered them and said, Verily, verily, certainty, I say unto you, you seek me not because you saw the miracle, but because you did eat the loaf and were filled. That is loaded. Let digest it. Let digest that individually. Let us digest that individually. Amen. Not looking for me because the supernatural thing you saw, you are looking for me because you ate the bread that you didn't know how it was baked. You ate the fish, you didn't know how it was multiplied. The thing that keeps you here is the prophecy. The thing that keeps you here is the healing anointing. The thing that keep you here is to believe that God is here. If not so, your Christian attitude will line up with the Bible. Praise the Lord. And he won. And this warning is to every true child of God. Labor not for the meat which perisheth, but for that meat which endureth unto everlasting life, which the Son of Man shall give unto you. For him hath God the Father sealed. Praise the Lord. Let our service, our worship, go beyond the flesh. Go beyond the thing that will satisfy the flesh. Because so many of us that I believe we have the Holy Ghost, brethren, so many of us, the joy we have today is tied to our business. The joy we have today is tied to our money. The joy we have today is tied to your fine car, good husband that guarantee marriage security. The joy you have today, young sister, is because you have a good husband. He has cars, 3-bedroom flat. He had BSc, he had HND. Brother, the joy you have today as a Christian is because your business is still booming. That business is still booming. That is where your joy is tied to. Amen. Did you notice when Satan came to tempt Job? He misplaced it. He said, God, you gave him so much money, so much camel, so much cattle, gold and silver, children. That is where he joined his title. That's why he's trusting you. Take those things away, he will curse you. Is that true? Is that true? Take those things away and Job will curse you. Thinking that Job's joy and service unto God were tied to what he had acquired. Amen. Because so many Christians today, they too shaking that we have in their business, they will be clothed with anxiety. A little shaking in their business, a little test of their faith. How can you be a Christian if you're a Christian? Go back, test your faith. You can't escape it. You can't escape it. If you are a true child of God, God will test your faith. And that thing, God believes that is where you are resting on, that is where he will shake to get you up from there, to look unto him. A little shaking, their confession will change. Their Christian standing will change. They will begin to imagine things. Oh my. Spiritual immaturity at the time of harvest. Spiritual immaturity at the time of harvest. How can you go in the rapture under that condition? Your faith, my boy, tested. How can your faith grow when business is booming? Money, nothing, nothing in the bank. Your faith is full of cow, okoroko, fish, gari, rice, yam, everything, boko boko in the house. How can your faith grow? No, never. For the captain of their salvation were made perfect through what he suffered. So he suffered and leave an example. Because he is the first among many brethren. He is the first among many brethren. If the first son went through it, other brethren must go through it. Certainty, certainty. It's not funny. Because many, their joy in this is tied to what they have acquired. People come to the altar and say, I love you. I love you. I love you. For better, for worse, for richer, for poorer. And then richness will come. Then when poverty enters more, their faith collapses. You thought you were joking with God when you come to the altar and say for better, for worse? You think God is your man when you come before him and say for richer, for poorer? Then he gives you money, then he gives you small poverty. You must take it. When you call it rich, what do you call poverty too? Then why are you complaining angry? When he give you poverty. When he give you riches, you didn't complain. Now he give you small poverty, you are complaining. How can you grow? You can never grow to be a pearl. Now your faith can look up. Because he must bring a situation that will build in the desired virtue that will make you a son of God, a daughter of God. Because it's not by mouth. By experience. Praise the Lord. He said, Jesus, why are you here? Jesus told them, why are you looking for me? You are looking for me up and down. Not because you see the signs and wonder. It's because the bread you ate yesterday. We are looking for me. Because they know they do not believe him. They do not believe him as the Messiah. If you believe as the Messiah, then you will accept his message to repent. Amen. He know they do not believe him. Hallelujah. For the signs and wonder, as I told you 3 Sundays ago, the signs and wonder will enable them to identify the Messiah. The miracle will enable the Jew to identify the Messiah. That was why when John the Baptist was in trouble, having introduced him as the only begotten Son of God, the Lamb of God that take away the sin of the world, when he entered trouble as a human being, he a disciple, go back and ask that man, I introduced the River Jordan, who are you? Are you really the Messiah? How can you be here? I am in trouble. Hallelujah. So some of you have been crying, Lord, why me? Lord, why me? Lord, why me? John the Baptist cry like that. Go and ask him, who are you? What did he tell him? What did he tell him? He said, go and tell him the eye, the blind see, the lame walk, the dumb talk, and the word is being preached today, Paul. Go and tell him. That will enable him to know who is on the ground. Amen. If you are seeing doubting because of situation, because of difficulty, go and tell him this is the sign. For it was prophesied in Isaiah chapter 35. That your God will come. And when he comes, the blind will see, the lame will walk, the dumb will talk. Amen. And did they believe? Did they change their mind? No. It was not, if he were not given to you to believe, no matter how we shout, no matter how we talk, you will not believe. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. May the Lord help us in Jesus' name.